Hi, everybody. This is Trisha. And Shauna couldn't make it today because she's trying to open her DayQuil pack, and it took some really big scissors. So anyways, we are out sick for the last many, many days. So we are going to give you a flashback today with a couple outtakes from some recent episodes. So hopefully you enjoy it. We will have Bench Write Club next week. Yes, it'll be the February Write Club at the beginning of March, but that's just how we do things here on the bench. Talk to you soon. Stay healthy.
1, 2, 3, 4. Sitting on the bench, writing's really hard. We need another snack, and that is just a fact. Oh.
All right. We are both in the red. In a good way.
In a lot of ways.
In a good way. There we go.
All right.
See? You can see it now.
All right. Hi, this is Shauna.
And this is Trisha.
And this is Two Girls on a Bench.
The podcast.
We rate on the bench.
We a snack on the bench.
Most of all, we procrastinate on the bench. Thanks for making fun of me, best friend.
No problem. I know a problem.
You're such a dork. Trisha's covering her face with like both of her hands because it was that funny. I don't know if anyone else thought it was that funny, but apparently she did.
I love you.
That was the best. Okay, now we're gonna have to cut it.
Start over.
Oh no, we don't have to start over.
Oh, just cut all that out.
Cut it?
I can cut it out.
And then you just put the laughing at the end.
And then psychic snot noises.
Psychic snot? What? I swear to God, that's what it sounded like you said. Psychic snot.
I have a runny nose, and so I was like, you know, snorting. Oh. My nose sounds.
I have no Kleenex to give you.
You know what?
What the fuck is going on in your house right now?
I don't know.
There's always Kleenex.
When I was gone, all the tissue boxes moved. The one next to my bed was gone.
It's the little blue man.
I replaced it.
Do you know about the little blue man?
It was gone. I don't know if it's my son or the little bitty man.
It's the little bitty man. Well, he is a little bitty man.
Oh,
so.
Wait. Here it is.
That's right in front of you. Do you know about the little blue man, though? Where they
little
come in like
blue men?
Yeah, they come and like rearrange everything in your house.
Blue?
They're blue.
Not the littles with the tails.
No.
We talked about this before.
No, it's the Twilight Zone.
Oh.
But it was when they did the new Twilight Zone. And they come and rearrange everything in every minute of every day.
Oh fuck. They're totally
so when
fucking
things are,
with me.
They literally recreate everything in your world every minute. So like if you lose something, it's because they didn't put it in the right place. It's pretty cool.
It's happening.
We got to find that and watch it.
It's happening to me right now.
Okay.
With my tissues.
Is this like an outtake?
What is this? I don't know what this is, but we can keep going or we can start over. There's two choices.
I feel like we have to start over.
Okay.
You have to get the giggles out.
It's flashback time.
That's funny.
Anyway,
so, well, we used it a long time ago in one of Trisha's old houses, actually. You've had three. This is your third house, Trisha. You're a grown-ass woman.
Fucking badass grown up.
But in your first house, she had a one-car garage.
Yes.
That was our little writing
space. That was her office.
That was the best.
We put... We just, like, used liquid nails and glued what's that called?
Foam corn?
No, it's not foam corn.
Yeah, you got foam corn in my head.
Cork board. We glued it to the wall. We glued all these cork boards to the wall so that we could just, like, pin up shit that inspired us. And we actually threw away a couple quotes that don't really inspire us anymore. And we're making new ones.
Yeah.
And we
She's got one of the boards that we had in our old space.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's, like, fun.
Cool, you know, retro shit, like a bumper sticker from Denny's that says what does it say? Night people don't get sunburns.
Trisha had that like when I met her in college. That's how old and vintage that bumper sticker is.
It's over 20 something years. And
I don't know how you've kept it all this time. It was like stuck on this bulletin board.
It's been on this bulletin board. And like, so is that gaggle of Todd heads you made. We have to post this on Instagram. So back when you had to use like a photocopier to make something funny for someone, Shauna found this retro card with like a 70s dude with an afro, and like, would you photo, you like took a picture of his face, and
I don't know what I did,
scanned it, and then
must have somehow copied it and then cut out a thing,
cut out a bunch of them.
We used to have a joke that like, I mean, sorry to any Todds out there, but like Todd was basically this mythical character that we all created with our husbands. He's
like,
actually,
well, he's like Chet from the movies. The movie with
the people in it.
The guy that had had another show where he was psychic. Anthony Michael Hall.
Oh, you did it.
There's a movie, Weird Science, and his brother's name is Chet. And Chet's like a total dick, frat, asshole to them. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
So some people like call their Todd like, oh, he's a Chet. But anyways.
Sorry.
That's not cool. I don't know any mean Chets. I only know one Chet who's nice. So anyways. Todd.
Wow, that went way off in a weird direction.
I'm super sorry.
I'm like,
I thought it would be,
what's happening right now?
I thought
now?
It would make people relate to the idea of this kind of guy, this kind of like jock asshole.
Yeah, he's just like a douchebag.
He's just like
douchebag. Yeah, I mean, I think everyone knows what that is.
Yeah, I don't have to re-explain douchebag.
So
like an example that doesn't make sense.
So there was a joke. We were all like, Todd, like there's just a bunch of Todds there. Like we used to say like, that well, all
we
the
went,
time.
We went to Vegas or something together and there were like a bunch of Todds.
And so then Edgar and Aaron were like, there was a gaggle of Todds,
yes,
which we thought was funny. So then I found this card. It was like a red haired, like 70s guy. And he looked like Todd, or it said Todd on the card
it
or
says,
something. Well, we should look at it. It's right
I
there.
Look.
But and then we found this card, Edgar and I, and we're like, huh, Todd. And then...
Oh. No, it's just a picture of a guy that looks like he would be a Todd. And you just took a bunch of... Oh, it says, it's your birthday. And like Todd says, do whatever turns you on.
That's why we said Todd. We're like,
yeah.
It's
so
Todd.
A gaggle of Todds wishes you a happy birthday. And Shauna literally...
A bunch of Todd heads.
Printed a bunch of colored Todd heads, cut them out in little circles... taped them, I'm assuming, to one piece paper and then photocopied it again to make this
probably
amazing collage of Todd's
it's
head.
It's super nice.
It's the card is all faded. You could, because this part isn't, because it was like this on the board.
Yeah.
So you can see the original picture, like
it's quite there. Stunning. It's
really
kind of
good.
Like I
you
feel
guys
like,
are gonna love it.
I feel like we used to spend so much time before we had kids and stuff, because like to
well,
do to make shit like that, like I wouldn't have time to do that now. I'd be like, I forget it. I
like,
give up.
Like the way you always had like a stamp for Angel, like your puppy's paw. Like you don't do that now when you send like Christmas cards or whatever. But like
I don't
we
even
both
know where my stamps are now.
We both mine are somewhere in my child's room, the bigger child.
They don't use them.
No, she's not interested in it.
No.
I bought her this whole.
They're
thing
not cool
stamps.
Anymore. We have a
like,
bunch of them. I don't know where
cool,
they are.
Cool. Let's get, you know, like this huge, all these shapes and colors and nope. And like we used to write letters.
Yeah.
Oh, so that brings us to this. So we used to write letters all the time because we didn't have the internet back.
Yeah.
Even, I mean, when I went away to college, my friends and I kept in touch.
We used to write letters
or
home.
Calling each other.
Yeah. And then like to your friends. From high school or whatever, friends that you met somewhere. And then also, when I was studying in Spain, I used to write a lot of letters back and forth to people.
Yeah.
And over the summer, we would write each other letters. It's so funny to
we
think about that.
We would send each other things in the mail.
And like
funny
pictures.
Things.
We'd do like shit like that.
Yeah.
We'd like send each other
photocopy
like.
Photocopy and paste stuff together.
But, and we did this with lots of friends, not just each other. Like everybody, like over the summer.
And a lot of pen pals.
That's so weird to think about that.
I was
now.
Obsessed with keeping up with my like letter correspondence, like as much as you would be on like it almost was like our Facebook, like that. That
yeah.
was the way you got mail in school.
But it was like better because,
yeah.
like, I mean, like,
there's something
like more
about
literate.
Getting a written
well,
letter.
It was more literate because
yeah.
we'd have to like write coherently what we were doing, and
yeah.
then we were like younger, so we were like, here's a beautiful quote from my Khalil Gibran book or whatever. Oh my gosh.
Both of us, I think we said this before, like I have notebooks filled with song lyrics and.
Yeah, we were like.
Emerson quotes and shit.
Yeah, I was like.
I'm like, I had Walt to rewrite Whitman. Everything down. Yeah, a ton of Walt Whitman.
Oh. Anyway.
We got to find that picture of us in the grass at the park in school, like with our feet in the air.
I don't know. I've got it somewhere. I have it. I think I have it too.
Yeah, my mom kept a copy.
Yeah.
But anyways, I don't know why I said that just now. We used to lay in the park.
We have uncovered.
Oh, speaking of water.
This kind of feels like this is the vault, dude.
This is like, okay, so should we do a vault?
Yeah, we.
Noise. I mean, we don't have to, but.
Well, I kind of feel like we found some old letters in the vault and then.
Okay.
The vault.
Okay, we're in the vault now, officially.
We are in there.
So we started out talking about how we cleaned this room out. And so we found a lot of things from the vault of our lives.
Days of our lives.
And then speaking of letters, I had this big envelope that was sent to me in college with a book in it, and inside of it though I kept all the letters from this guy
I
met. It's
so bizarre. Let's
call him Mr. M. So met Mr. M. We used to go to this coffee house in Agora called Lose the Blues, which is like a dance studio or something.
It's
now.
Way long gone.
And it was like what we would do on Friday, Saturday nights or whatever when we had time off. We wouldn't go out drinking.
When we were young. Yeah. Well, we were only 19.
No, yeah. Hey, 19. So we would go and listen to band. Like there would usually be like some guitar player bands there. And this guy was like there. And we would
wear our patchy pants and like be cool and put on like a weird hat and like drink some coffee and lose the blues.
Yeah, and like play board games on weird, you know, like overstuffed.
It's like an episode
couches.
Of Portlandia is kind of what it reminds
it,
me of
it does.
Now, actually.
It kind of looks like
that,
the woman
dream of
the bookstore.
90s. Yeah. Yeah, that's totally what we were doing, seriously.
So anyways, so this band was playing with us, just like mostly like tiny, like not really a band, more acoustic guitar type thing.
Playing like Steve Miller Band
songs. Yeah,
they're
just playing like
covers.
Steve Miller covers and stuff. And I really, my dad listened to like a lot of that music and I liked it. And so... But the guy came out, Mr. M, and started talking to us because we were smoking cloves. Do you remember that? And it was like, I don't know, we wanted to smell like Cinnamon Toast Crunch. But,
like a ham.
I know. And we were like, it's almost Easter. Let's get ready with these cloves. I'm going to make a wassail.
What? Wow. That's
like a tea. Cranberry drink, and you put slices of oranges and you stick cloves in it. It's a thing.
Okay.
It was in the 80s, at least.
But that's not...
Anyways, moving on.
It's a far cry from the loser.
You know
blues.
What?
All right, go ahead.
Just stop it. So Mr. M asked me for my phone number. And the thing is, he was about 20-something years older than me. I was 19, and he was, like, almost 40.
And I don't... I'm not trying to be mean, but he wasn't, like, attractive
super
or anything.
Hot. But I like.
But he was interesting.
I like musicians.
Well, you did marry one.
I did marry one.
You do have a type.
I have a type. Although he wasn't like my type in like the way his face.
No, he was not a good looking. I'm trying to remember what he looks like.
He was just a total geek, but he. I don't know how many pictures of him, but he was just this big dorky guy, and he just seemed cool. And I was like, I hadn't been on a lot of dates. I'd only had a couple boyfriends. And I was just like kind of enamored with the idea that this, like, I was away from home and an older guy asked me out and I could do what I want. I put myself in a super dangerous situation.
Once again.
And not to quote my favorite murderer again, but I'm lucky I fucking didn't get murdered because this guy turned out to be
a total
crazy
effing psycho, or I can just say fucking psycho because that was some fucking.
Yeah.
So these letters are like First of all, they're on this weird stationery.
Like
these flowered envelopes that like my Aunt Claire would send me when I was a kid.
Like on purpose to like send
yeah,
to me?
Yeah, he was like, this is a beautiful envelope with like a very nice, you know, like floral design on it. And I'm like, yeah, these are literally like the envelopes I'd send back and forth to my aunt that lived in New Jersey when I was like in junior high.
And then it's like double rule lined paper on the inside.
And then he would write crazy shit on the outsides of the envelopes though. That's when it felt weirder when I was looking through these. Like when we found these, I was like, why did, cause you have to read the weird shit that he wrote on the outside of the envelope. Cause like that almost feels like
just
the,
read the first
like
sentence.
The postal carrier should have like,
yeah.
Confiscated
so this
it.
Letter says, warning, this is a love letter. If you are offended or embarrassed by declarations of love, do not read. Okay, now guys, I went on one date with him to a Mexican restaurant like in Chatsworth. And then I did go back to his apartment and I had brought a swimsuit because he had told me had a jacuzzi. And I don't know why.
Bow, chicka, bow,
I know, right?
It sounds like that, but then
so, but
no.
Like it wasn't like that though, because I wasn't really that kind of girl at that point. And what? And so we did go in the jacuzzi, but one of his neighbors came in. So there wasn't like a bunch of funky business happening.
Yeah.
He did kiss me. And we, like, made out a little bit, like, when we got back to his apartment. But it was, like, nothing even to first base.
Yeah.
Right? So then he wanted me to stay the night. And I was like, I have to go. And I left my suit there in his bathroom because it was wet. And then I left. I mean, I got dressed and then I left.
Okay. I didn't get naked with him. I was naked and walked across the shore.
I just like took my bathing suit off and I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna just go for all of no. That was not when I would that was not a naked time in my life. I was
oh
not.
Oh my god. Yeah.
So anyways, I changed and left. Okay. But that swimsuit's important because after that, he wanted to like go on more dates with me. He came to our dorm once, I think.
That was weird. I remember that.
To visit. And we sat in the room and listened to Everybody Hurts, and he was trying to teach me how to play it on guitar.
Oh, my God.
Once again, Trisha, musician.
Repetitive song.
And repetitive song of R.E.M. So anyways, so, you know, we just, like, hung out, though. We didn't go anywhere or even make out or whatever, I don't think. I don't remember. So then
this letter's so crazy, dude.
Okay, so then I didn't really want to see him anymore. Like, I was like, this is weird. Also, it was weird. He kept making all these references to, like, how much older he was and how his knowledge was different than mine. And, like, the book he sent me in the mail was about a 51-year-old falling in love with a 19-year-old fan. And, like, he...
crazy.
He kept talking about that song, Hey 19, where it's like, we can't dance. We don't know the same songs. We don't know... who the same
because
people are.
Because you're old.
Yeah, because you're young.
So, okay, I'm going to just read.
This is a letter that came out of the envelope that says, this is a love letter. If you're offended or embarrassed, do not read. But just the first two lines are fucking
so, okay,
amazing.
He wrote that, by the way, everyone, on the outside of the envelope.
Yeah.
So that's like a warning that you're crazy. So then you open the letter and it says on the top, like in, yeah, it's on like, you know, like lined paper. Like school paper, and it's like LA is burning out of control, and so castles made of sand melts into the sea eventually. Is that from a song or
yeah.
something?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, but then it says this. This is the part that's like slightly psychotic. Trisha, 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 dot dot dot. That's how the letter starts. I'm not kidding. I can't stop thinking about you. What does this mean? Your Vanderbar.
He put a definition.
Form or frame. Oh, he like was like, because you don't have a big vocabulary.
Yeah, you're an English major, but you might not know what this means.
I did not know what Vanderbar. I still don't. And I even got.
These are all,
my
is
degree.
There a date on that one?
It's November 2nd, 1993.
So I have earlier letters from October.
He's crazy. And then he's like, you're. Vanderbar, which apparently means form or frame, vocabulary word for the day, everyone, crosses my path again and again. Last night in my usual bout of insomnia, I composed thousands of love letters in my mind to you. I mean, it's like...
He was 36, by the way, I just found
and
out.
He just met you, like, and you went out once.
Yeah.
And that's it.
Yep.
What a freaking crazy person. Well,
I think he met me in October, and we were writing by November he was completely smitten.
Okay, and so then, by the way, Trisha kind of has this effect by on men, December, or she did, you know, a long time ago, like before she was married, where the men would just like fall for her and like just like lose their minds. But like this, because. Sad to say, she does have another stalker story after this one, but it's a whole different situation. But we'll talk about that one later. So
here's one line from this this letter in October, which is, I think he was like, I'm going to send you some letters. And I was like, all right, after he like came and visited me. And then I didn't think it would be any big deal. I don't recall writing him love letters back. I think it was more like,
here's a song I heard. Yeah. Yeah, something.
I don't know. So he was like, so it goes on and on. It's all talking about age difference. That he's 36 and I'm 19. And he's like,
like he fell in love with that idea.
He's saying, if I could be your lover, I would eat a cricket or covered with chocolate. So like, you are 19 and I am 36, .. Tell me, is it crazy for me to be hugely attracted to you? I, who was 17 years old when you were going glurg, glurg, I gotta be dreaming, right? This is insane, isn't it? What would our parents think? What would the logistical ramifications be here? Would your dad disown you? Let me pause. And Trisha, please, do not panic. This is only my own romantic speculation, that is all. Sure, I would love to be your lover, your traveling companion, etc. But first and foremost, I want you to be able to realize all of your desires and goals free of hindrance.
What? Like,
you need to maintain your focus, find out what you're about and where you want to go.
He's all, this is insane that an older man would like a younger woman. I'm all, not in Los Angeles. Wait,
don't let me scare you, punkin. P-U-N-K-I-N. I'm quite harmless, so if you tell me to go away, I'll go away.
He's not harmless. Somebody that writes...
is like a 7-page letter.
Read the outside of... Give me that other envelope. The crazy one that has like a bunch of shit on it. That one is psycho.
This was when he was... So this is later, I think, when I stopped talking to him. This is when it started getting
really weird.
And he's like... I stopped corresponding with him because these letters were freaking me the fuck out.
So this is December.
He sent me a bunch of mixtapes too, guys.
So first, it was like... You met him in October, by November. By December, he was fucking crazy. And it's like...
Well, even this...
December 2nd, 1993.
Wait, October
3, I mean.
6th, he wrote me this 7-page letter. And then October 14th, there's another letter that came. And he's like...
Like a week later.
I can't stop writing you letters. Like, he's like... Okay, go ahead.
On this weird rose and Claire paper.
Yes.
What is this paper? Sorry. Okay. So, Trisha, this letter was written by me... on or about September 23rd, right after you began to exhibit hugely aloof and erratic behavior towards me,
AKA,
for God knows what reason, as your conscience bids you. P.S. I initially wavered in deciding whether to mail it to you, but here it is. I'm sure you're thrilled! Exclamation point. No, this entire... I have to, like, post this. P.S.S. No letter is complete without a P.S. But this is not the letter. This is the envelope, you fucking weirdo. This is the envelope.
And he put in it another love letter to me that I guess he had written before. Weirdest shit ever. This is like a weird... We're like actually doing this live. We didn't look at these beforehand.
No, we found them and we were just freaking out looking at the envelope.
All we saw was the...
I'm all mad. I'm all...
Jeremis Marsak. Okay.
Where's the one where he said you were like, you died the same day as Jim Morrison or something?
No, on the tapes. He sent me like 4 mixtapes in this one. The Blues and Haikus and Zappa are for you. Traffic, Leslie Gore's for Larissa. That was our other roommate. Psychedelic is for Shauna. Beautiful Shauna. And then underneath it, it says, nothing is for me.
What?
So he says...
So he sent me psychedelic music?
I don't remember.
Do you remember?
He was doing playlists for us of songs he said that he thought we would
funniest... Have. He did. I do remember he said something weird to me. He was like, and you, I will miss you most of all. Like the Wizard of Oz.
Yeah, yeah.
And then I was like, that's funny.
Yeah.
And then like...
It's kind of like weirdly charming. Like,
but yeah, but like, okay. But like, no.
Why, Trisha? Why was I so dumb?
I don't... You were 19.
I'm lucky I didn't get murdered. I really am.
Well, like, I was almost in a cult, so, I mean, we all have our faults.
I was close to that situation as well.
It's just, we didn't know.
This one started like this. Hello, this is December now. How are you? Are you okay? Why don't you want to talk to me anymore? did I do or say something that you found to be offensive? Like maybe that I think you're beautiful or that I love you? Because, Trisha, you are beautiful. Is it so unusual that I should be attracted to you? Why? At any rate, this abused, maligned child hasn't a clue as to what he did to deserve the straight arm. So he was an abused child? Like
what the fuck happened to this guy?
I'm thoroughly saddened and confused. All I wanted to be was your friend. You're mean, but don't worry, bucko. You'll get yours. Like EC says, further up on the road, somebody's going to hurt you like you hurt me. You're only damaging your own karma, your own credibility, and you'll need it later on. I can only assume that your political affiliation is Republican. Why did he jump to that? Anyways, here's hoping that brain disease.
He's like mental health. We need to get some meds. Here's what's going on.
The brain disease.
I mean, that is making disclaimer. Me not a nice I'm person. Not saying anything mean. I mean, we all take meds. Yeah. But like on, you know, borderline, like some sort of crazy. Something's not working up there. I should have
probably gone to the authorities with this.
Seriously, letter. But doesn't he say something about just cut to the Jim Morrison? Isn't there something like you were born on the same day as Jim Morrison?
He
says
that he hopes the brain disease that made me not a nice person is curable.
And this is from an older person also, mind you.
I was 19.
Which is funny because it's like you would think we would be the stupid immature stalkery ones, but instead he was. Once again, Trisha did have a magnetic effect on me.
16 millimeter shell. He goes, I'm worried about you. I know that under that 16 millimeter shell of yours is a really nice girl. What's that mean?
I don't know.
I'm through beating my head against the wall. If I see you, I'm going to pretend I don't know you. The secretary is going to disavow any knowledge of your actions. Oh, here he is. Well, you were born on December 8th, and so was Jim Morrison of the Doors. He was known as the Lizard King, so it can only be assumed that you, Miss Trisha, of Corona, are the Lizard Queen. Your dark, brooding, personality seems symbiotic to Jim somehow. Check out the Doors movie and let me know what you think, okay? this was like December 2nd.
So no.
Anyways, happy birthday, Pumpkin. My only wish is that you pop out of a cake and I lick all the frosting off your celestial body.
He's so fucking crazy. That was that went all over the place. He's like, you're an asshole. I hate you. He's like, I love you. Jim Morrison.
And then he goes, P.S. Remember the first four letters in Pumpkin are punk. P.S.S. It occurred to me that I spend all my time wasting my time. Yours forever. Oh, shit. I said his name. Beep. So he has his birthday. He put here born and he put his birthday and he put died December 8th, 1993. He died on my birthday to me. He's dead to me now.
He is. Oh my God, Trisha, I'm so glad you didn't die when this happened. Because I would have been like my friend Trisha that died when she was 19 because this crazy ass person.
This is crazy, dude.
No, and it was a death threat. I remember when we read it.
I remember reading this with you all.
No, you were read it out loud to us and we were in our dorm room and we were like, Trisha, you can't ever talk to this guy again.
I hadn't been.
And then we were a little bit worried for a minute. And then we were like, and then we were like, whatever.
Yeah. And we just moved on and I never talked to him or saw him again. Nothing happened. He mailed back my bathing suit. That was one thing that happened that I had left it at his place.
I did not remember that I was privy to my own mixtape.
You.
I feel very special right now.
You had your own.
Anyway, that was a lot. And that was also
big learning lesson.
Awesome.
This is that the last you kept letter. This.
Oh my God. We all keep too much stuff, but this was so. He even says,
here I am assaulting you through the printed medium. Ta da! This rose is for you, by the way.
Aunt Claire paper teacher. Again.
Hey, Pumpkin, you stone, you babe, you total fox. Oh, my God.
Well, if you ever feel, down or bummed, you can read these to know that somebody was completely obsessed with you at one point. Not that that should make you feel better because it's a psycho person. Psycho. He went, that one thing went so all over the place.
It is crazy.
That you're there's something going on, for real in his brain that's not right. Because, you don't write like that if you're, okay. Anyway, I think we need to take a break and have a snack.
Oh, yeah. Shit. I forgot the snack. Sorry. Okay, bye. I mean, not bye. Cut that out.
Give me that snack book!
snack. Stalker snack.
Stalker snack. This is from the Popcorn Factory. This is another Home Goods bite.
Found a lot of snacks in line at Home Goods.
It's called Confusion Pop. No, Corn Fusion Popcorn. I'm sorry.
It's a sweet favorite
and salty trio of gourmet popcorn, including classic cheddar, cheese, rich caramel, and salted butter. So I will tell you that the salted butter is like stale.
Yeah, it tastes like what you buy at a fair in a big plastic bag that like isn't popped fresh.
That's not good. And then
but you the cheddar is like,
The caramel's good.
The caramel's really good.
I'm going to chew into the microphone. This really picks up sound well.
I keep just picking out the caramel ones.
There's more caramel.
Oh, it's like they're trying to do that Chicago popcorn where it's cheddar and caramel, right? Or caramel. What is it, caramel or caramel?
Caramel. Caramel. I don't know.
Caramel.
Caramel. I don't know.
Anyways.
Yeah, that one's good. And that one, that really good one that I used to get from work from like events. The cheddar cheese. It was called Chicago Mix. It's cheddar popcorn. But the cheddar popcorn was so, remember it was so fresh? Mm-hmm. I'm reminiscing about another snack because this one is kind of like,
We were disappointed.
I love popcorn. So
there's a popcorn place in Agora, I believe, that we should probably go look up. It's like they have all different
flavors. Was it called
Lose
the Blues? I'm just kidding.
No. Shit. No, it's not.
Mr. M.
Yeah, he works there. No, it's someone gave us a present from like two bags of popcorn from there for Christmas, and they were like amazing. So I didn't save them to share with you. I ate them. I am.
So we made a list of reglas.
While we're for eating our popcorn.
A list of reglas for, you know, any future woman who finds herself in the situation that Trisha was in with a stalker. Reglas for potential stalkers.
Yeah. These are the, if you run into these things, you have a stalker. Look, I can't believe I didn't tell anyone, especially about that last.
When he's like, I died.
Death threat. Yeah.
It was kind of like, I'm going to kill you. Mm-hmm. We're so lucky you didn't die. Okay.
So happy.
Here's the reglas. Folks, listen up.
Folks.
Young ladies out there. All right.
19-year-olds.
Yeah. If there's any 19-year-olds, don't. Okay. Just listen to these reglas. Okay. Okay. Refuse his many mixtapes. Nowadays, what would that be? A playlist?
Can you share a playlist with somebody without them owning the songs?
Shit, I don't know.
You burn it on a flash drive?
We just right now got super old. Just in that one moment when I said I couldn't know about a playlist.
I mean, I think we probably got super old when we talked about writing letters.
Yeah, that's true.
Because that doesn't happen anymore.
So, regla number two.
However he's giving you all his favorite music to listen to and telling you what the songs mean and how good they are, like that, it was just a little obsessive.
That's not a regla.
No, I know. Oh. Jeez.
Sorry.
That was a continuation of number one about the mixtape.
This one got crossed out and I'm confused. Okay. Don't open an envelope that says this is a love letter. And then
has sarcastic things written on it.
Number three, before that, don't give him your address.
Yeah. Why? Why? Why was I giving our address out to strange men that were 17 years older than me?
If he's way older than you and gives you books about older men dating younger women, don't go there. Just don't read that book.
That book was sent with the last.
Don't go to that jacuzzi.
That book was sent with the last letter.
He was like, maybe I can convince you with this book.
Like this relationship worked, so could ours. It's your fault.
Beware. Number, I don't know what number this is because I didn't number them. Okay. Even though I was saying numbers.
Here's another one.
Here's another regla. Beware if the train of thought in the letters goes everywhere and circles back to you being at fault. Mm-hmm. That's like some weird psycho.
Yeah.
Schizophrenic.
I don't know. He needs to go to my therapist.
Like he's like that guy in the movie. He's schizophrenic, right? Where he's like, where they think like people are. There's conspiracies and like,
yeah,
remember Beautiful Mind? Yeah, remember that? Yeah, he's beautiful. I'm going to call him Beautiful Mind. All right.
Oh.
Be very.
I would call him Scary Mind.
All right, Scary Mind. Just kidding. Yeah, because that guy was, like, smart.
Might have killed Trisha once, Mind.
Wait. Be very...
It's too long. That's...
Shh. Okay.
Stop judging me.
Be very worried if he pins your bathing suit on his psycho bulletin board with photos and sugar packets from your one date at Denny's. Okay, we kind of made that one up, but it seemed like something that would have happened.
He had my bathing suit for like months before he sent it back after I.
We kind like, of imagined that he like pinned it up.
I think and I then, threw like, it away once he sent it back because I was like weirded out.
The whole yeah, I feel like you ripped something up.
I ripped
you
up
got
something.
Freaked out.
Yeah, I remember that. I don't think I saved all the letters. I ripped them up. I was
be skeptical
upset.
When he tells you his life story immediately.
Yeah, very intimate details of his life story that you don't want to know. And his brother's life story, too. Like, oh, what?
Yeah. Wince when he calls you pumpkin.
No.
Punkin.
Like how his father says it, like pumpkin.
But he said, like, punk.
Yeah, well, when he
you're
was pissed
punk.
At me. He
but
said,
at first
he was
it was
like,
cute.
Oh, you're my pumpkin. No, it was weird, though, because... He never called me Punkin when the two times I saw him in my life, but he decided in his letters.
Right. Let's remind
that would be my
everyone that you only hung out with this guy twice.
Twice.
And this
I went to dinner.
Progressively weird.
Yeah.
Crazy ass letters. Yeah. Okay. So get the fuck.
Apparently, that's all it takes to fall in love with me.
Trisha is magic. Oh. She is just. She's a. What are they like? Sirens or. The ones that like
succubus.
People just flock to her. Okay, here's another regular. Get the fuck out of there. If he writes the same word over and over again, like your name, when he's
yeah.
like Trisha, 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 Trisha.
Yeah,
that's creepy.
Totally fucking weird.
And finally, what we didn't do but we should have done is call the authorities when he says he died on your birthday.
Yeah,
because like that was just.
It also sounded almost
right.
like a suicide threat. Like I should have, because it was. Earlier
somehow,
in the week when I got, my birthday was coming, so, and he put that on there, so it was
like. He was going to kill himself?
Yeah.
Yeah, like, I didn't even think that. I was thinking, like, he wanted to
then.
Kill you.
I'm thinking it now, because I know more than I did when I was 19 years
also,
old.
Also, it was so weird. We were like, what's wrong with this guy?
Oh, we were just, like, hoping.
But we didn't know as much as we do
now. He wasn't going to show up at our dorm. Yeah. But, I mean, there were key cards and whatnot. Rocking and rolling.
Wow.
That has to be my favorite noise that you make. It used to be when you like.
It's my weird John Travolta noise.
I don't know.
And he never does that, but for some reason I think of him when I say it. Anyway.
All right. Well, I think that we've about stalked you out with this whole conversation here. So
we hope that you have, you know, learned something.
Learn from my mistakes.
Everyone.
But
boys,
also
learn not to be a stalker.
Yes.
Girls.
Everybody.
Don't participate in that.
Boys can be stalked too, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah. There's like, you know, you know like
anybody can
spoil your
anybody.
Bunny. What was that movie called?
Oh, yeah. That Mouse.
Nope. No. Oh, no. You're like Meryl Streep.
Keep her soft.
No, what? Michael Douglas and Glenn Close.
Glenn Close, that's
what's
what
the movie called? I just forgot.
Obsession?
Nope. I need like a little sound effect.
I love you a whole bunch.
What the heck is that movie called? Oh my god, it's gonna drive me
crazy.
What? Tell you everything about it.
I'm gonna find out right now.
And she's like, I will not be ignored. That's like when Glenn Close was crazy awesome.
What's the movie with Glenn Close where there's a rabbit? Question mark.
That is not. You're not gonna get anything.
Fatal Attraction.
Oh, it did.
First thing that came up on Google does it again. Like, that was amazing.
Oh my god. All right, well,
so
they don't get a Fatal Attraction, guys. That's where that was
well,
going.
And if someone does send you weird shit, you know, and you're a creative person, I mean, I could see why I kind of saved this. I don't know what I was gonna do with it.
It was just like so weird that you needed to preserve
it. I like kept it in this little envelope for all these years.
That's so funny.
That's so crazy.
I'm so glad it was like a time capsule.
No, that's fun. That was definitely a good vault. And if we pick the caramel popcorn out of the snack, I think
we can
remedy.
Like, maybe save this snack. All right, everybody.
Snack.
Next time, we will see you. But we won't see you. We'll just talk to you.
No, but follow us on all the stuff, like Twitter and Instagram and stuff.
Oh, yeah, and like rate.
Rate our podcast.
Review it. Like, just
if you like it.
Be part of our lives.
Don't like it, you just tell us privately.
Don't.
I'm just kidding.
If you don't like it, just don't. If you have nothing nice to say, don't say anything at all. That's my
yes,
rule.
Yes, mother. And also, if you have writing prompts, we asked for one.
Oh, yeah,
or like
prompts.
Also night terrors. Remember, we were interested
night terrors.
In that.
Yeah, if anybody has any night terrors,
nobody's emailed us yet. So
email us, two girls.
We're lonely. Don't email us like,
but no stalker
too much.
Stuff.
Yeah, but a little
we're
bit.
We're kind of opening ourselves up to that.
I know, right?
Two girls on a bench at gmail.com.
I'm not going to give out my address though.
Follow us on Twitter. Instagram. Don't give them your address.
At two girls on a bench.
All right, later.
Booyah.
This was a podcast from the Podfix Network. You can check out more shows like it at podfixnetwork.com.
If you're new to the show,
Nope. If you're new to the show. Sorry. I've teased you about that.
Like I shouldn't say it?
Yeah.
Oh.
Because you always do that. So I always say so. And then you always go, so, if you're new to the show. I'm sorry.
Okay. So I suck at podcasting.
So do I.
Boom.
Trisha's really good at
I'm
all.
Not going to say that anymore.
No, because remember we talked about it?
Yes.
Because you always are like worried about all these new people.
Just want to make sure everybody feels
we can just
included.
All this out.
Maybe.
But like every time you listen to a podcast, like you're not like, they're not like, if you're new to the show.
They do though. They'll say that sometimes. Like this is a podcast where we dissect pop culture or.
But did they say if you're new to the show?
Oh, no. Okay. This is a podcast where we procrastinate our writing projects. And we like to start with a quote.
Yay.
That, like, was painful.
It was really painful. You can just cut all of that out. Nobody wants to hear that.
Nobody wants to know how painful that was.
Nobody wants to know how mean I am or how nice you are. Nobody cares. Just kidding.
I might just leave it all in. Just so everybody can see how mean you are.
No, but... It was just because we talked about it.
I know.
It wasn't because I was like trying to be mean, actually.
Right. Should I introduce that again so it's not so hard for me to edit?
One more time.
I don't
I was like, what's she going to say? You were like.
All right, wait, just stop.
Sorry.
All right, we're going to go right now. Boom, shakalaka.
Wait, I don't have a quote.
Oh, shit, fuck, damn.
God damn it.
Okay, so Logan keeps saying to me.
Shit, fuck, damn.
Hey, Mom.
Oh.
Kids shouldn't say God damn it. I tell all my friends at school they shouldn't say God damn it. And I'm like, God damn it, Logan.
That's good.
And he's like,
really good.
He's like, Mom, that's a grown-up word. God damn it. And I'm like, yes, it is, but you shouldn't tell your friends about it. He's like, I just tell them not to say it.
He's like, shut the fuck up.
He's all, guys, guess what? I got the lowdown. My mom, who has a fucking potty mouth, don't say God damn it.
I mean, I know, and part of me is like, I can't say anything because I have like the worst mouth. And
I say
I
God,
always have.
God damn it's the one that leaks out in front of my kids, though.
I've said so many bad things.
Well, so if I like stub my toe or like the other night I hit my nose with the door, the back door, I was like shutting it and I like was really tired and I hit my face and I slammed myself in the nose. And of course I was like, God damn it. And he's like, Mom, that's a grown up word. I'm like, I know it's a grown up word.
Girl, and I'm a grown up saying
and
it.
I'm a grown up.
Done. Don't
and
you
I'm
say
in
it
pain.
Stop telling everyone else to say
but
it.
Don't tell your friends not to say it because then you have to say it not to say it. And that's like double negative.